about well-run people anyway. There's just three categories of people according to what I've written. And that is white people, non-white people, and white supremacists. Just three. Rather than the 21, our brother, that I've heard about.
Yes.
So, the white supremacists, in answer to another question, that is correct. You can't be supreme over something that doesn't exist. So in order to be supreme over non-white people, you have to have non-white people. So it doesn't make any difference what the shades of color are. People say black people and brown people. That's the term. They're putting the words again. Black people and brown people. Well, when you look at millions and millions and millions and millions and millions of black people, are brown people. And a lot of brown people are black people. What's the difference between one shade and another? It's just a shade of black. Because anything that has color is a shade of black when it comes to skin color of people. That's just the way it works. From black people, you can get brown people, light brown people, dark brown people, yellow. Some people say yellow, some people even say red bone. But basically, it's black. From white, you don't get anything but white. And the white supremacists understand that. You just keep getting white color. That's it. And that's what a lot of white people want to preserve. And there shouldn't be a law against that. Shouldn't be a law against anybody being white. Just like it shouldn't be a law against anybody being black. But the white supremacists have said that if you're black, you are automatically a criminal. And your crime is being black. And that's something black people throughout the world have to understand in order to understand white supremacy. You are born a criminal. And your crime that you committed was being born black. That is a crime in the white supremacist lexicon, in the white supremacist philosophy. Being black is an absolute crime. Against what? Against everything that has any decency to it and anything that is constructive value, which is why you can go around and destroy anybody who's black, because that's automatically a criminal. That's a worthless person. I mean, in fact, it's not even really a person, like they used to say, it's an animal. Like the character in the movie Godfather said, sell drugs to animals, to the black people, to the colors, because they're nothing but animals anyway. They're not even people. You don't have to give them any regard. They don't matter. Why should they matter? I mean, you kill animals, don't you? You kill squirrels, you kill chickens. You kill cows, you kill black people. You know, in fact, they're not worth as much as a dog.
Hmm.
All right? I just alluded to something that a cousin of mine, years ago, World War II, he came home, what he called his home, from the South Pacific after World War II, a soldier. And he walked up to a white man, trying to be friendly. He was happy to be back and whatnot, and didn't get killed over there in Okinawa. So he said, how are things going? And he told me this himself, and I was maybe about 13 years old. He said, well, same as usual. White man first, dog next, and then he used the N-word. Negro last. White man first, dog next, and the N-word last. And how tough. And he said that was his greeting back to Arkansas.
Wow.
After fighting for freedom.
Mm.
But the guy told him, the white person, answered him, you know, how are things in that manner? Let them know, hey, the Dolphins.